The government's decision yesterday to buy back the rail network from Australian firm Toll Holdings is being supported by South Dunedin Labor election hopeful Claire Curran.
Look, I'm passionate about public transport, in particular rail, and I just think this decision is an investment in our future. It's an investment in rail and it's an investment in the future for New Zealand. So it's only good news for Dunedin and for the whole of New Zealand.
However, her view is, unsurprisingly, not supported by her main rival for the South Dunedin ward, National Party candidate Conway Powell.
It's daft. Firstly, it's giving a huge dividend to Australia. They bought it for about $245 million, I think, and they're selling it for $636. That's a huge dividend going across the Tasman. Secondly, that money could have been spent on struggling New Zealand families. Food's going up, people's going up. Why give it to the Aussies?
Whereas Maritime Union organiser Victor Billow, whose members look after much of the freight around New Zealand and the inter-islander ferries, says the government's decision is a solid one. As history shows, the privatisation of the networks in the 1980s hurt the industry.
Well, the history of it's been really unstable over the last generation in terms of the ownership. I mean, it was sold off in really poor circumstances back in the 80s and 90s, sold off to overseas corporations. They had no interest in New Zealand or New Zealand's welfare. Their interests were in stripping the assets, getting as much money as possible out of it, and then going off. And even in recent years, that's still been an issue with the lack of investment. So I think really now the government's taken the bull by the horns. They're moving in the right direction. They've got a lot of way to go yet, in our view, in terms of getting the transport infrastructure working. But we think they're making the right, the right direction in it, and we're glad to see it's back in the ownership of the people of New Zealand.
The Labor-led government agreed to the more than $600 million purchase price, with Finance Minister Michael Cullen describing Toll Holdings as reluctant sellers. Channel 9 viewers will be able to get the National Party's full position on the sale and the upcoming election when National Party leader John Key is interviewed in Nine Local News this Friday. Daryl Baser, Nine Local News.